Hi, I'm going to tell you about two really useful features that I use in the Tesla app for my Powerwall 2. So let's get started. Hi, John Tisbury here. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more about my Tesla Powerwall and solar installation, or more about photography and cinema photography, start now by subscribing and clicking the notification icon to be notified of new content when I upload it. I'm going to take you through the Powerwall app, the Tesla Powerwall app, and two of the features that I really find useful. And they're not easy to spot, so you may know about them or you may not. The first feature I'd like to talk to you about is the ability to see the underlying data in the graphs. I'll bring this up on screen so you can see it, and I'm just going to go into Power Flow menu from the home screen and then click on the bar chart option up in the top right hand corner, and this takes you into the energy usage screen. And then from there, you've got your icons running across the top for your inputs. So home usage, solar, Tesla Powerwall, and from the grid. And I've clicked on all four of those to make them active. If I scroll down, I can then see the usage from today. And I've got the optional drop-down menu there to look at the different historic looks from yesterday to the week, the month, the year, depending on how long you've had the setup. What I like about it is if I forget to record some of my details, because I capture everything in a spreadsheet, so each day, end of each solar day, I record the previous day's activity across all of the inputs. But if I forget, I can still see that data via the app. So what I do, if I go into the week view, and go back to the chart, which gives you a bar chart with all of the icons that you've chosen at the top, all of the inputs, so I've got all four shown here. And then, for instance, on the Monday, if I want to see what the data is, the underlying data, if I click and hold on that bit of detail for that day, it then shows me house usage on Monday the 25th was 24.6, solar was 20, into the power wall, out of the power wall, to the grid, from the grid. And then you can do that for each particular day that you're interested in. And if you go for the month, then you can again look for the month. It'll show you the week's worth of data for that particular month. So I find that quite useful. If I've forgotten to write down my data for a particular day, I can go back into the app, and as long as I'm within that week, it will then be able to show me day by day exactly what it did. So yeah, let me know down in the comments if you find that useful, if you use that particular aspect of the app, or whether that's new to you. I sort of stumbled across it when I was playing about with the app, and I'm like, oh, that's quite useful. The second feature I wanted to talk to you about is the ability to scroll through the graphs. So it's sort of similar to what we've just looked at. So if I go back into Power Flow from the main screen and then click on the chart options from there. And once I've got my grid up on screen, I will then actually click on the grid, and that brings you a vertical line. And then you can scroll left and right along the timeline that you've got there, and it will then show you at a particular given time where you pause. So in this moment, I'm on Saturday, March the 2nd at 10:15, and it shows you the activity for all of your inputs. So our house, 3.8, solar was 1 kilowatt, nothing to the power wall, and pulling 2.8 from the grid. And if you go and look at the peaks, kids are playing in the garden next door, so hopefully you can hear me over there. There we go. So here at 12:05 on the same day, Saturday the 2nd of March, the house was using 3 kilowatts. The solar was producing 3.5 kilowatts, which meant that 0.6 was going to the Powerwall and we were sending 0.1 to the grid by the look of it. Sometimes I find that when we get a swap in power between one and the other, so it goes from the grid to the solar or from solar to the Powerwall, and the grid pops up for a fraction of a second while the gateway sort of resets itself. So I don't tend to worry about that because it is just where it's switching between one or the other. So they're the two things that I wanted to show you in the app. Hope you found those useful. If you have, then do give me a thumbs up or thumbs down if it wasn't particularly useful. Do drop a comment down below because I'd like to know what you're thinking and what you're using and how helpful these are and your thoughts. Plus, if there's any bits in the app that I haven't used or come across, it also would be good to know as well. If you haven't subscribed, then please consider subscribing and click on the subscribe button down the bottom there. And I'll see you on the next one. All right, take care. Bye.